Welcome back. Another episode. We know y'all missed us. It's been a while. We're sorry.
We missed you too.
As you can see, I'm on a tropical island. not real. But yeah, we know it's been a while, but we moved back home.
We've been home for 3 weeks now. Mm-hmm. Today, actually, 3 weeks. And yeah, how's it been for you?
It's been weird. Mm-hmm. For some reason, this has been the weirdest time coming back home.
Bro, literally.
And I don't know if it's because, like, the more, like, years we spend away, it's just weirder coming home. Mm-hmm. This is the first time where I kind of had, like, such a realization of, like, the kind of lifestyle we're actually living, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
Because the other times it's just been, like, I came back home, whatever, it is what it is, you know, you go back to normal. And this time I feel like I've actually, like, almost had to like pause and be like, we live a crazy lifestyle,
bro. And no, it's actually insane.
And also it made me kind of be like, you know how I feel like it would be so easy to just like live here the whole time, and you know,
right?
And I'm like, why can't I just be satisfied with that? But yeah, so it's been weird this time. Yeah. For real. But it's good though.
Yeah, for me as well. Like, it's been hella weird. Also, like, I feel like I'm still somewhat jet lagged, which is crazy. I've been home for like 3 weeks, but bro, this jet lag has been terrible. I've been thinking about it too. Like, it's just like, no, this lifestyle is actually crazy.
Right.
Like, I don't know why we keep doing
this. Yeah, for real. And it's like, it's always like, obviously when we left, like it's always, it just gets harder and harder to say goodbye to people. Right. And I feel like this year, I think also we really, really, really liked KC and the people we met there. I feel like this was definitely the hardest goodbyes to people.
Bro, he was crying on the way to the airport, bro. Like, nah, this shit was actually, like, the hardest. And then it's just so crazy, like, because we leave here around, like, January or February. Like, it's cold, it's snowing, like, blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. Then we come, and it's, like, summer, but it's, like, so much has changed, but at the same time, like, everything's the same. And we lived a whole different life. And then we come here, and shit's just the same. And it's just, like, so weird, like, oh, well, let me just get back to this lifestyle. Because our lifestyle also back home and back in the States is so different. So, like, let me just come back
here. Yeah. That's what I felt, because I literally, like, we landed on a Wednesday, and I went to work Thursday morning, like, literally the day after. And I was at work, and I was like, so what happened when I was gone? And it was like, nothing. It's the same stuff going on that was going on when I left. And I'm like,
right.
We've lived a whole different life. And then I've been talking to some people that were, like, in KC. And I was just, like, you know, doing my stuff here. And I finally, you know, have my own car back. You know, I can go whenever, wherever I want. And they were like, oh, you're, like, a whole different person. And I was like, I'm not, like, a different person, but the life that I live here is so different from the life I live when we go to play football.
Right.
Like, you only get to see really one side.
Right, yeah. And because I feel like that's the thing, because people think, like, oh, like, you come back, you're so changed. Like, yes and no, because at the same time, like, no, I'm still the same person. It's just, like, I got used to a different lifestyle. And the thing is, like, even when we go to different places in the States, like, we still get used to such different lifestyles in different places. Like, lifestyle in Houston is way different than lifestyle in KC.
For sure.
And then it's, like, when we're around certain type of people for 6 months, like, I feel like it's only natural to, like, kind of change a little bit, which you are supposed to anyway. Like, we're supposed to be changing and growing. Like,
right.
I feel like that's a compliment when people say, like, oh, you changed. Like, because usually we still change for the better. But it's just like, yeah, you come back and everybody else is the same. And I was like a whole, like, not a different person, but like living a whole different lifestyle and everything. And then coming back here and everything's just the same. Like, it's just, I don't know. It's weird.
Yeah, it was different. But I mean, it's good. It's cold as shit. I've been freezing. It is so cold here. It's been, like, the worst summer in years in Sweden.
That's crazy. It's been, like, decent here. But for other people, it's so funny now. Like, when people are like, oh, it's a hot day. And I'm like, hot? Bro, I fucking struggle getting used to the daylight thing. Because that's the worst part. Because
we leave
in
the winter
when it's fucking dark all day. And then in the States, it doesn't... The daylight thing isn't the same. So it's still, like, regardless of what time of the year it is, it's still dark at night. Like, the sun still sets by, like, what, 8 p.m.? And then you mm-hmm. come here in the middle of the jump. We got here, what, daylight. In June? That is literally the worst time. The sun doesn't set at all. I'm like, bro, I'm fucked in the head. I'm already, Mama. Like, my brain is already, like, I'm thinking it's 3 p.m. when it's nighttime. But then also the fucking sun is up. And it's like, yeah, I grew up in that. But people don't understand, like, it's so different when you come to it all of a sudden. Like, we're not used to it because we were gone for 6 months. Like, for other people, yeah, it's like that for the winter. But it starts getting more and more and more, like, little by little. But I come from complete fucking darkness to complete fucking daylight. Like, just like that. Like, no, it takes time to
that was sleep. Crazy. Like, the first week, I was going to bed, and it was, like, 11:30 p.m. And I look outside, and it looks like it's 2 p.m.
Literally. And because also, my like, brain ow. Already thinks it's 2 p.m. anyway. So it's just like, right. How am I supposed to believe that it's midnight?
But anyways, you got some news. This week?
I do. So, I'm back in Finland. I'm also back on the Finnish football field, which is crazy. So, I signed with the Turku Trojans. If you haven't seen on Instagram, go check it out. I signed with the Turku Trojans to play in Finland. I haven't played in Finland in 5 years, which is crazy. Is it that long,
though? I was like, did you not play? Didn't you play, like, 2 games or something?
Yes, but that was 5 years ago. Before that, it was 7 years ago. No, 8. Wait. No, seven.
Because you played with Turku at that point too, right?
Yes, so I played for Turku in 2019, and I dressed up for 2 games, but I think I only played like one half each game, but I was just like getting dressed to be ready for the playoffs.
Oh, that was after you were in Karlstad.
Yes. So after I came back from Sweden. Yeah, because I literally left like the day after a championship game, right, in Sweden. Yeah. And then I played like, I dressed up for like 2 games in Turku. And then
I felt like it was after DC. That's but no, it's way
no, because I was injured. I got injured in DC. That's why I missed the Worlds.
Oh my God, it's been that long.
So it's been 5 years since I even dressed up. But since I've actually played, it was 2017. That's crazy. Which is crazy. So I'm back. So yeah, I got a couple more games left. It's game week for me. Woo, woo, woo. Which is actually funny because we play in Vaasa, and we play at the stadium that used to be my home stadium when I coached the men's team in Vaasa. Right. But I've never played there. I've only coached there. So it's that's my first fun. Time I get to actually play there. So
yeah. I get it, though, because I've been, like, now since I got back home, like, I've been at the gym, and I'm like, yeah. I have absolutely zero fucking motivation, because what, I'm supposed to do 9 months of off-season? Right. Hell no.
Right.
Like, what am I supposed to do? Because you know you can't start your your off-season yet because you can't do it for 9 months.
No, this is literally the split where usually I have like 2 months of I just do whatever the fuck I want. Whether that's not working out at all or working out however the fuck I want. And then I lock into off-season training.
Right, but I'm so bad at doing whatever I want at the gym. Because you know how like we're so used to having like a workout schedule? Yeah. Like when I'm standing there and I'm like, how do people work out? Right. Like how do I do this? You know what I've done?
What?
I started going to classes.
Listen. You gotta be specific. What kind of classes?
Okay, so first, so I was like, you know what? I'm gonna start, you know, I need to get, I'm gonna take care of my body. Okay, this is gonna last for, we all know it's gonna last for a month. So I've always wanted to try Pilates, but they don't have it where I live. Like, there's no Pilates. So what they do have, they call it, hot body balance.
Yeah.
So they actually heat up the room that we're in.
Yeah.
And then it's like a mix of yoga.
Yeah. I can't imagine you doing that.
What I tell
you're
you,
practicing so for our after football lifestyle because
oh hell yeah,
I don't know. We always say when we're done with football, we just want to be housewives who just go to Pilates with their little Stanley cups and then have brunch afterwards. And we need to be neighbors.
Cause, and also, you know, these freaking instructors, like this instructor, she was probably like 60 something and she's fit as fuck. And I'm
bro, they be humbling you. People that do like Pilates and shit, like they're actually strong. And because you don't use those muscles other than in Pilates because it's like the deeper muscle. Them older women be fucking humbling you, bro. That's also why I can't do it. Why I can't go. Like, if I do Pilates or yoga, like, I need, like, a private session. Because ain't no way I'm doing this shit next to other people.
And I was so. And then you know how I hate feet?
Yeah.
Why everybody got to take their fucking socks off in there? Nasty. And then I'm stupid. And I did, because I didn't work out for like a week when I got back home, because I was like, fuck it. And then the first day in the gym, of course, I go do legs.
Oh, yeah.
I swear to God, for 3 days, I could barely sit down.
Yeah.
And I had this fucking yoga thing. My legs were shaking after 2 seconds. I was like, I can't do this. I looked so bad. And then they got you laying down, and you're supposed to, like, breathe, relax, you know, because it's also, like, mindfulness shit.
Yeah.
That's not me. You know, like, I can't. So I'll be laying there, and I'm like,
I can't imagine you doing that.
No, so I was laying there, and I was like, okay, so now, okay, can I turn around? Yeah. Or if I, otherwise, I'm just going to also fall asleep.
Right.
Like, there's no in between.
Right.
So, but I did that, and then I also did a cycling class.
But that I can see you do.
I do, yeah, because that's honestly, because yeah, because honestly, I've done that a lot before. That's like the only cardio I can actually do, because I don't run.
Nah.
So that was kind of, that was all right, but yeah, I don't know how to act in the gym anymore, and I'll just be like,
I don't know. But that, yeah, that's part of also the how the lifestyle is so different. Also just like, bro, we're so used to like, we always go to the gym around the same time in the morning. We always like have breakfast fucking at the same time, and then we go to gym. Right. Like, we have a schedule there. Because usually it's like, for a lot of people, it's kind of like you have a schedule at home and then you go to another country and it's hella different. But I feel like we have a schedule there too, even though it's not like our schedule is not packed. But we have somewhat of a routine. And then I come here and I'm like, oh, I can actually go to the gym whenever. So it's also kind of hard, because then it's like, because when we go, I know, okay, I have to go to the gym at like 10, 11. Like, even though we could change it too. But now when I'm here, I'm like, I'm gonna go right now. Like, you know, like.
And I'm like, do I gotta even go? Do I even gotta go?
Like, technically, because you're not pushing me. Like.
And also, because one reason we do go like in the mornings is usually because we got meetings for practice in the evening.
Yeah.
And I'm like, wait, so I don't have practice or meetings or anything?
No, I've been going to the gym in the evening now. Well, now I started practicing again. But before that, yeah, I started going in the evenings. Like, I was hitting, but also because of jet lag, like, I would be up at night. So I would be going to the gym at, like, 9 p.m., be hella up.
Yeah.
But that was also, like, we had our, or my first practice with the team yesterday. And, like, I've been going to the gym and everything, but bitch has not been hitting the field. Bro, since, like, we did all the all pro practice and the game, which was, like, what, four drives per play
right.
our rotation. Other than that, like, because we didn't even do anything. We just went to the gym between playoffs and all pro. We didn't hit the field. And I haven't hit the field since then either, because I wasn't thinking that I was actually going to play. So I go to practice. I've hit the field one time just to see if I can run before I sign. Like, fuck it. And then I go to practice yesterday, bro, my hip flexors today, I'm like, ooh.
Imagine.
Ooh. It's crazy how quick it is. Like,
that's what I was saying. I took 1 week off. Right, that's what I was saying. I took 1 week off, maybe a little, but yeah, pretty much 1 week from All Pro. And I did one leg day and I couldn't walk for 3 days.
Bro,
I'm like, how am I supposed, am I not supposed to be like,
am I not fit?
Like, what? That just makes me think, like, I cannot stop playing football.
Right. No, literally.
Because what?
That's what I'm saying. When people do, like, they play football for, like, 10 years. Then they take a break for, like, 5 and get back. Get back?
You're back.
See, if I quit, like, I can take a year off and I'll probably have to just to let my body rest. But, like, I'll still train like I'm playing football. I have to. I can't take a year off from just being
athlete.
Because there's literally no coming back.
No. Because that's what I'm saying. Like, when we've been injured, I've done rehab and then still been working out as if I'm, like, playing.
Yeah, but I
can't take a year off and not. Or even when I hear, like, people, they're, like, that's playing. And they're like, no, I don't really be hitting the gym. What?
How?
Because, like, I could not just go and hit the field.
No. Yeah, I don't get it. It's been an adjustment on all aspects.
It has.
Anyway, so we've been home for 3 weeks now. Before then, we obviously went to the Nine Cut weekend and played the All-Pro game. So that was a fun. That was hella fun weekend. And I think, like, that was a good weekend for us to, like, end our season and to, because we then flew home Tuesday. Yeah, so we then flew home on Tuesday after the weekend. So I feel like it was a nice, like, ending weekend and then come
back. It was, like, the perfect finish because there's a lot of people there that we knew. It was fun to meet everybody. But then also it was a lot of people from our team.
Yeah.
Like, pretty much, like, half of our team was down there. Yeah. So it was just so fun to get to do, like, one last weekend with the team. Yeah. Because after the playoff game when we lost, everybody kind of scattered in their own thing. So this was like the perfect end to this season.
That was definitely what we needed, like, especially us too, but I feel like as a team as well, like, everybody got together, or like half the team was there, we would be spending the whole weekend together, like watching the other games and like going out and stuff, and then obviously like seeing everybody else as well, just meeting other people and stuff. But more about the weekend, we filmed a little vlog, so we're just gonna play the vlog here and then we're gonna get back and talk about some other stuff. So let's go into the vlog. We are on our way to Dallas.
Can you come in?
We're here, we loaded up in the car.
Mayo, Lauren.
Shout out to Mayo and Lauren.
You just had IHOP.
It is 11, we left at like 6. And yeah, it's Friday, so we have all pro practice today and it's moms.
Gotta have the nachos.
Hey, quick trip, quick trip. Nobody else has nachos, but quick trip,
quick trip. Yeah, what you know about nachos?
What's nachos?
It's like a Celsius, but it's better.
It's a Swedish brand.
BCAAs. Isn't that some workout stuff?
Yeah,
it's kinda. But it's just like...
It's like the pre-workout. Goals. Yeah.
It's just caffeine without sugar. Yeah, you should get one. Not coming?
You didn't say it. And you put it in the wrong spot.
Well, because I couldn't push it back and you can be working for a quick trip. Little pit stop in the middle of nowhere.
Roddy's not a fan. I don't know where the fuck we're at. It looks
it's country.
It's a motel. All right, we're here.
Finally.
But to go in and register,
get our shit,
our uniforms.
We don't know what we're getting or what our uniforms look like, so it's gonna be
a surprise.
Hotel.
We got our stuff.
So we got these bags and we haven't opened them yet. So we play for different teams, right? So we're gonna have like different jerseys.
And I think we got different cleats and stuff too.
Yeah. Blue.
I'm wearing black. It's gonna be hot as shit.
I didn't get my own number, but they gave me close enough.
Okay.
I like these. That's kind of like last year's.
The other way around.
Yes.
I like them though.
Yeah.
Apart from like the fact it's gonna be so hot.
Yeah, they have them wearing black and it's gonna be like
100 degrees. Because I like the colors. Otherwise, but yeah, it's gonna be hot.
Oh, shorts?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I kind of like this model. Hold on. Wait.
No, these are nice.
Oh, this is a nice model. It's like the short ones. Yeah. They usually give like the basketball ones. Oh,
no, these are nice.
Gloves.
Did we get the same?
Yep. Yeah, same gloves. These are just like, you can't really use these with a lot of teams. Like, I would never use these with the Glory.
Right.
But I mean, I'll practice in them. Adidas.
They're nice.
Yeah. They're smooth.
And then cleats. Nice. I got these. So these actually match.
Wait, these are the cleats that I was about to buy, but they didn't have my size.
And I got the ones that match the gloves. I don't use these kind of cleats. So it is what it is. But
you can sell them.
Right.
Or auction them out.
Right. But they match the gloves. So this is kind of nice. Adidas socks. Black one.
Oh, I got white ones.
And then we got a towel. Really, we got like these bracelets
things. And then the bags. And then our tags.
Nice though.
That's it.
Nice.
So right now we just got to the hotel. We're just gonna grab something to eat, and then we have practice in like an hour and a half.
So we changed for practice. About to go back to the Star and have 3 hour practice.
Back from practice. We just had 3 hour practice. We had to like split. Wow, my hair is so crazy right now. So we had to split so that my team started like outside and they started inside, and then we switched.
We basically just like ran through plays.
Yeah, because I mean we had to learn the playbook like today.
So yeah, we're just running in songs.
Yeah. So that's pretty much it. It's like 9 p.m. right now or 9:20. Now we're trying to figure out what we're gonna eat and then go to sleep.
Tomorrow we have media day at first.
Yeah.
And then the game is at 7.
Yes. So see you tomorrow. So we're gonna wake up ops tomorrow.
It's Saturday, and it's, what time is it?
Like 10.
Yeah, about to be 10.
We're getting ready to go to the media day thing.
So take some pictures. Beating our face right now.
And then, yeah.
Last night.
Yeah, we got guests.
Or this morning. We got Shannon. We got Dre over there. We got the wheelchair. We got the crutches. It is 9:50.
We got the alcohol, the medicine. Let's gotta do what you gotta do.
We got the 18-year-old.
Haven't even eaten yet, but it's fine.
No.
Coach,
not good.
Yeah, where's all that trash talk that you usually?
I don't. If you said it like that, I feel so bad. You know it is.
At least the braids look good. At least some look fresh.
Is he crying?
No, I'm not crying.
It kind of looks like it. Oh, okay, big money. Big money counting dollars. We're at the 101 event. We got some of the all pros doing the 101s right now.
She ain't even got a chance to catch it because the passes are overthrown.
Right.
Watch Rocky. Let's run.
Should I go? Honestly? In the flip-flops.
Line up. Line up. Fast as fuck, boy.
You're getting cut.
The fuck? Yeah, but where did the ball go?
Like this situation down here, that would have not happened if she listened to us.
It can't get worse. It can always get worse.
Went to play flag and got worse.
Where the fuck is Spencer?
Where is Ryan? He said he was gonna be here between
10 and 5. Damn, we look tan.
Oh no, wait, I look a little. Anyways, our ride is like 5 minutes late already. Like, we got a game to play.
We're taking this seriously. We got a game to get to.
He texted here when he wasn't even here. Fuck.
Easy. Always fucking
late. Kelly.
Last moments together.
Fuck you.
Fuck you, I hate you.
About to go in these separate locker rooms and then it's over with.
I hope you lose.
See you after the game.
Hope you lose. Bye.
We're friends again. Well, maybe after she gets a drink. I'm cool.
Listen. Why'd they pull a Casey on us and score when it was like 40 seconds left? Or a fucking Mississippi. What? Why we keep doing this?
I don't know, but I'm okay.
You think you did something? They both broke. Can't play. The fuck?
Hey, we still won though. We still won though. We still won. What the fuck can you say? Yeah. Yeah, look at you.
My tight end scored a touchdown.
Hell yeah.
I'm an elite coach.
Say hi to the vlog. Winner, winner. What's up? Say hi to the vlog. We love winning.
Hey, y'all still lost in the playoffs.
Hey, at least we ended the season with the win.
Yesterday's news is not today's news.
Oh, how you doing?
Winner, winner, chicken dinner.
Yeah.
No, I swear to God, if you fall backwards right now, I will.
I'm a pro.
You know, that's how you know.
So quick shower and now we're gonna go find food or we're gonna go to the same spot as
I'm trying to make sure you don't take your pants off.
Oh no. So we're just gonna go to the same spot we went to last night and then we'll see what other people are doing. I think like everybody who played like all pro and shit is going out tonight.
Like everybody
from our team. I think everybody from all pro are trying to go out tonight. Probably. So we'll see what we get into, but first we need food because goddamn. Good morning, day three with, well, I slept a good 6 hours. You slept like a good 3. Shannon has yet to sleep. And here we are. Fuck it, we ball. And it's like 11:30 right now. We're about to go watch our flag team play. And Shannon's gonna play, so we gotta get her there, you know?
I'm gonna be game day ready.
Yeah, you know.
Game day ready. Yo, call me up. Where's the music?
Right, where's hey, y'all down. It's about to go down in a minute. Let me touch down.
Oh, we got here representing.
Oh, yeah. Get your merch. Had dog mentality with a code for huddle.
Hey, we ask for our
20% off.
Took us about an hour to get in, but we here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Amber.
Ooh. I ain't gonna lie, that was like shit.
So far, they beat Mississippi, lost to Tennessee, which is kind of crazy that way around. And then now we're playing Washington, and It's not going
down by
great
two, so far.
Two touchdowns. Yeah, it's halftime though. So we got time, and we made a little quarterback switch. So I don't know. That might work if they keep doing that. So
we ball.
I'm just saying. We went to
right
the store drunk to get you a whiteboard, and you threw that shit on?
Yo, what?
This girl really just went to the wrong hotel trying to ask
for refused to leave,
then realized she's at the wrong fucking hotel, pulls up here, just sits in a wheelchair and is eating sunflower seeds.
To save money.
All the power went off, and they said that the power went off like everywhere. Like, we're literally right by the Ford Center, and they said the whole Ford Center went dark. And the championship teams are literally warming up right now. And we literally just got our food. They were like, this is literally the last pizza we could serve because the power is off on that. So we don't know what's gonna happen to the championship game now, because they said, and the waitress said that last time this happened, the power was off for a whole day. So we don't know if there's gonna be a championship game today. So we're about 30 minutes late, but we just got the power.
We got the power.
Power back on. You trying to be in? We just got the power back on, so we get to play.
Lauren, game shut
up. She does not get to play. Ganging this bitch.
Ganging.
Hey, score predictions.
Yeah, what
score predictions.
24-25.
You said what?
24-25.
To who?
Texas.
I was going to say 27-24.
To
Texas.
Mississippi. I'm gonna say like it's like 7-14.
Yeah,
14,
it's not gonna
21.
Be that many.
And I hope it's Mississippi. I really hope it's Mississippi.
I think it's gonna be like 12-14.
Yeah, it'll be like 1-2 touchdowns.
I hope Mississippi.
Shit, it might even be like 8-10 or some shit.
17-12. I want Mississippi to win, so let's go.
Go Mississippi.
Go Mississippi. Why are y'all not singing?
Why do we have to sing the national anthem?
They kind of sound good.
Hey, they kind of sound good.
Oh, God. Are you speaking?
You sound good.
So, from what we've seen, Mississippi started with offense. Turbo, their starting running back, is actually starting a corner.
For Dallas.
And she's, yeah, for Dallas. And she's not starting a running back. So, what's going on here?
What's the game plan?
Popcorn.
All right, so that was the vlog. You got to see a little bit what we did. So we just quickly wanted to talk a little bit about free agency because honestly, I did not think this many players were going to clear for free agency right away. But it's been crazy. Has been
popping. Like, since the season ended, I'm pretty sure, like, the day after, like, the championship game, the portal started popping. And the thing is, like, every day is somebody new, and it's actually big names. Like, I'm so, like, this offseason is actually, because it's already wild, and it's been 3 weeks. So,
but, like, and not even, like, clearing for free, but some people even already signed with
new
teams.
Yeah, a lot of people have already signed. So,
I was like, I did not, when I saw those posts, I was like, what is going on? How?
And it's a lot of players you wouldn't think. I think the biggest name in free agency right now, and this came out like a few days ago, is definitely Turbo Thomas.
Yes.
Number 15 running back for Texas. I did not, like, that was a shocker for me because when you sent it to me, I was like, what?
Is this
like,
a joke?
That is not even something that, because there are players that you would be like, oh, like, maybe, look, I wish we could recruit her, blah, blah, blah. But that, like, I just didn't even think of Turbo, like, leaving.
Right, and it's crazy. So, if we just jump into it, honestly, there are, like, and I'm counting Sick now because she did play for Dallas this season. There are four big names coming out of Dallas clearing for free. And there are more people, too, but four really big names that played for Dallas, they all cleared for free agency. We got Turbo.
Sick. Weatherhead, number 9, mm-hmm. the linebacker. And then number 10.
The DB.
Yeah, their corner, number 10.
Right.
They're all big-time players.
Right, so and then I think there's a couple others from there that has cleared for free agency as well. And that is so interesting to me because, like, you know, I mean, they lost one game. Or, like, they lost two games, but they lost 1 year. And all of a sudden, all these names are clearing for free agency. That just makes me think, like, what is going on? Because if nothing is going on, you would be like, okay, we had a bad year, but we can come back from this.
Right.
But when people start leaving...
I feel like, because I think some people are speculating it as in, oh, they came here to win, but now that they started losing, they're ready to leave. Like, I don't think it's just because, like, every team fucking loses at some point.
Right.
We know that for sure now. So it's like, I don't think, and players like Turbo and Weatherhead and these, like, they're not, I don't want to believe that they're the kind of players who would just leave just because they lost the game. Like, no, there must be more to that. And obviously there could be situations where maybe they're trying to move anyway, or like,
you
know, because I think there are players who kind of know which team they want to go to just because maybe they want to move there or something, but they're just clearing for free agency just for more of maybe the excitement or something. So, like, it could be like, okay, she's moving from fucking Dallas to, let's say, KC, but she's not announcing that she's going to KC type shit. Like, you know, it could be something like that.
And then, you know, some people might do it also just, they might sign back with Dallas, but they just want to see what options there are.
Yeah.
But I think it does, you know, make you, like, it's going to make people speculate on what's going on when big names like that. And also when it's all multiple. It's not just one.
Right.
And then a lot of players from another team has been Seattle. A lot of players from Seattle has cleared, which is also interesting because they had their best season in years.
Yeah, that was weird to me because I was thinking, like, this was the season for Seattle where they was like, okay, we're really going for it now. Like, they really had a good season. So it's like, I feel like if anything, like, you would have expected everybody to stay in Seattle and plus some, like, now players from around coming to Seattle, but it's been a lot of players leaving. But what we did hear from somebody who played for Seattle last year is that their player fees are really high, so I think that probably plays a part in it. But yeah, it's interesting. But they have been also signing a lot of, I guess, Oregon players lately. I guess that's, like, closest to Oregon, and some Oregon has also been, like, losing a lot of players in the start of
college. And it's also because I feel like it's also a little sad. I mean, obviously we don't know who they're gonna bring in because I feel like if Seattle would have kept, like you said, most of the players and then brought people in, they could be a championship team next year too.
Yeah.
So now if they have a, like, big rotation, It'll be interesting to see. Yeah. And then
We said this year. We said last season's free agency was interesting, and that's why this season was more interesting. The power rankings are gonna be impossible because it's I don't know. Like, it's just gonna be such like different type of players.
Right. Yeah. And then there's like just some players from each team that has clear. We got Faux clear. She played for Mississippi. It's also interesting, you know, you got people playing for the team that won the championship clearing. Right. We got London for Houston. I saw there's some Philly players, obviously, because they're not playing anymore.
Yeah.
Which is interesting. I was like, do they even have to clear for free agency?
Right. Yeah. I don't think so, but I guess they just wanted to get their name there.
But what I will think is interesting at the end of it is like also interesting what teams does not have a lot of people clearing.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot of teams that they haven't had anybody clear for free agency yet. But it's so early still.
Right, because it's literally so early. That's why I was so shocked that it's already so many people. Because, that means I feel like you must have known for at least half the season that you were leaving.
Yeah. Especially when it's teams that did good. Because it's one team, if your team didn't make the playoffs, you would have had some time to think about it. You maybe felt it during the season. But if your team was, in the playoffs or even the championship game, that was 3 weeks ago.
Yeah, you knew before the season ended.
Right. I understand, clearing for free agency is one thing, but then you also have people who have already signed. Yeah. And one of them is Rambo. She's an all-pro running back. She played for Seattle. She's already signed with Dallas.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, and that's interesting because we were talking a little bit, and I'm like, did she sign because she knew Turbo was leaving? Or did she not know all these players were leaving and signed, and now she's
everybody
like...
Everybody else is leaving.
Right, because if I signed with a team and I didn't know all these players were leaving and then I saw it, I would be a little bit like, what the heck is going on?
To me, it would... And obviously, this is all speculation. We have no idea. We haven't spoke to any of these players about their free agency stuff. But, I feel like, to me, it would make most sense that she would have signed because she knew Turbo was leaving.
Right.
But then again, I don't know. It's just, it's just interesting also, to see now then. And then there was, the Oregon running back, Chris, already signed with Seattle. And is that because she knew that Rambo was leaving? Or is it, is this just a chain reaction?
Right. It's like a domino effect.
Yeah. So it's definitely interesting. But I also, I do love that for players, though, that more players are clearing for free agency and looking for where they actually feel most fit. Because I feel like in women's football, for so long, it's been you just play for the local team. You just play for whatever team is closest to you. But that's not necessarily your best fit. So I do love that players are now, more open to relocating or traveling to teams, just to be able to find the best fit for them. But then also, I feel like there's obviously players who just keep switching teams until they become a starter somewhere. Because they, it's always players who also, they just keep switching teams because they just want more. And it's like, at some point, you got to build with some team. Which is a lot for us to say. We've been switching teams every year. But obviously, our situation is a little different. We got to go where we can afford to, basically.
And also, I like it because I feel like it's also a little sign that owners and coaches have gotten more gravy on recruiting as well. And it's good because it creates a bigger competition about players. And that's good for us as players that more teams want us because we can start asking for more.
Yeah.
So I think it's good. I think this offseason is going to be interesting.
Yeah, I think it's this whole free agency kind of set up as well to where you have to clear yourself for free agency. And now them having whoever created, I don't think it's the official page, but the NFC portals, it's good that you're you have a place where you're posting all of it. Because last season when we cleared for free agency, we had to clear for free agency and then they say that they're going to tell all the teams. But, a lot of the teams didn't know we were free agents for weeks. So, and we never got, information, okay, now your name is out here or now your name is on a list. It's not public like that. So, I really like that they have made this page. Which obviously, it's not official. So, I think if you clear for free agency, you're going to have to reach out to them and say, hey, I'm a free agent.
But it's still better.
Right. It is still better. Because then also, I kind of also like that it's not public just because some players don't want to be posted like that. Like, they just want to have private conversations and whatever. But yeah, I feel like that's definitely a good platform. So shout out to whoever created that. I think that's good. But it's definitely like also just now because like you said, like it's going to make the coaches and the owners also work harder to provide what these players need. Like, you're not just going to stay somewhere just because it's the closest team. Like, you actually need to be treated right and you need to be provided with certain shit. Like, obviously don't ask for too much, but you know, like, it's still gonna like elevate the game for women and the competition for women. So I definitely like that for us.
So we're excited. We're gonna try to, you know, keep y'all updated on what's going on.
So we've agreed to do like a little monthly episode. So now obviously that the season is not on, like, and now that we're back home and we got other lives again, we don't have the time to be filming every week and we don't have like necessarily as much to talk about. But we'll definitely do like a monthly episode and we'll just talk about all the free agency stuff. So as always, let us know if there's anything you want us to talk about, or like if you have some free agency tea or whatever, spill it, you know, spill it to your girls and we can put it out there a little bit.
Right. And then we'll also, like, once we start knowing, obviously, more about our situation and, you know, what things are looking like for us, we'll, you know, update that.
Yeah. And I'll keep you guys updated on
on your season.
That's we get another month now.
We need the stream link. Okay, we need the views. Yes.
It's on a finished app, though. I think I need to see, because you need to download this. I think you can use it on internet as well, but it's in Finnish. But I believe you might be able to download it in other countries as well. It's just in Finnish, though. But you would have to subscribe. But I'll put the link down below.
Do they need an English commentator? Because I'm free.
Can you just come film on your phone on like YouTube?
Not for real.
Just commentate it yourself.
Right. Or you know what I should do? You know when people like do streams, or what's it called? Like on Twitch, they be playing games or streams. I should do that. I should be watching the game and commenting in English.
We'll look into that. It might be some type of copyright issue. But,
right.
If anything, you can go live on like our Instagram page.
That part.
And just film the TV or some shit. But yeah, so I have two regular season games. I think we're locked in for playoffs already. Or we are. And then it's only one round of playoffs. So as long as we win that, we have a championship game. And then actually the week after that, I did agree to play for the national team as well. So we're playing for the silver medal against GB in GB.
Okay.
So, you said you wanted to pull up to London to come watch me play, right? So
I should. Which day? When is it? August?
August 18, 17, that weekend, Saturday.
Let me check my calendar and I'll get back to you.
All right. Thank you guys for watching and thank you for being patient with us not posting for a little bit, because like we said, life's been a little hectic and we've had to figure this whole new way of filming and everything.
Technology.
Technology thing. But thank you guys for watching and
thank you
on our Instagram, and then we'll post another episode in about a month. Bye.
Okay, oh.